last week during our full ant room tour update video. We fed my biggest ant colony in the ant room, our OG fire ant colony, we call the Fire Nation, some sweet jelly and an entire cockroach. This was actually the first time I offered them food on this open rock platform in quite a while, just so we could see them for filming. Ordinarily, I drop their food directly in the thick vegetation around their mother nest, where the ants would finish off their meals in private. But this feeding would be different, and it wasn't long before I noticed something quite strange. This is what the feeding site looked like several hours later. Usually the fire ants would be swarming all over this food. But here, as you can see, there were only a few ants. Where did all my fire ants go? And what I saw a few hours after that brought a sick feeling to the pit of my stomach. There, did you see it? Wild, feral, black crazy ants and ghost ants were inside the Fire Nation's territory. This never happens. The territorial pheromones of the fire ants were enough to scare all feral ants in my home from coming anywhere near this tank. Now, they were seen inside. Something was terribly wrong. What happened to the Fire Nation? Where was my most beloved and biggest pet ant colony of my entire collection? There was only one way to find out. Please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. Welcome to the AC family. Enjoy. I couldn't believe what I was seeing. Ghost ants and black crazy ants entering the Selva de Fuego, the Fire Nation's massive Paludarium kingdom. I even spotted one black crazy ant making away with a dead fire ant worker. What had happened here? Well, I got to the bottom of it all, and I explained what I believe happened, so keep on watching until the end. I couldn't believe that just a few months ago, the colony looked like this. Millions of ants swarming above ground in celebration of their annual nuptial flight event, where reproductive males and females hope to mate with those of other fire ant colonies. Of course, seeing as I don't have any other fire ant colonies in my room, all the reproductive queen hopefuls and males ended up not mating with anyone and dying out within the territories, like they do every year at this time. It was shocking to see a colony I've had for over 4 years go from millions to just a few. This fire ant colony was definitely the most popular ant colony on this channel, and I would say was responsible for taking this channel and all of us AC family where we are today. The Fire Nation has accumulated over 153 million views collectively. Their first breakout viral video, My Fire Ants Are Planning an Escape, currently has over 39 million views. Shortly after, they showed us the savage side of nature in the video, Cockroach Giving Birth While Being Devoured by Fire Ants, which was featured on Nat Geo and Discovery Channel. Together, we watched as the Fire Nation devoured Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton during US election season, and showed us the miracle of how they survive floods by literally creating air chambers using their bodies and by floating on water. They showed us how they amazingly could walk a tightrope to get to food across my room. When the channel hit 1 million subscribers, I tested my luck by placing my honey-covered hand into their nest, at which, of course, they riddled me with stings. On Christmas, we gave them a glittering cockroach Christmas tree, which they devoured lovingly. Eventually, they moved from their formicarium to this enormous half-land, half-water simulation of the Amazon River and rainforest, which they dominated and ruled for 2 very epic years. We marveled at the Fire Nation's display of blood and flesh lust as they tore apart a bird-eating tarantula, a chicken head, a mouse, a monitor lizard, and even compete with an army of maggots for a decaying turkey head. They even gave me battle scars on occasion to remind me that they were an ant colony to be respected, a super organism and force of nature that wasn't playing around. We've also been lucky to spot Her Royal Highness a few times, the Queen of the Fire Nation, whose name is Queen Solis, sole egglayer of the colony, birther of this ant army of millions, who once even narrated an episode. There's no denying that this ant colony, though the most challenging ants I've ever kept, always keeping me on my toes, was also one of the most amazing collection of animals I've ever had the honor of caring for. And so, it was time to get to the bottom of what had happened to the Fire Nation. It pained my heart to put on my gloves, knowing that this could possibly be the last time I'd be arming myself to go into the Selva de Fuego, the kingdom I had built with my own hands, just for them. My heart raced as I stared down at the location of their mother nest. If the Fire Nation was still alive, they for sure would be in here somewhere. My mind started to come up with possibilities. Perhaps they had eaten a lot and weren't so hungry. But no, that had never happened before. AC family, it was time to get our answers. I went in and removed the driftwood that formed their mother nest. I looked for fire ants, which ordinarily would be swarming right now, as they did the last time I worked in here. And AC family, what I saw next shocked me to the core, as the entire life of the Fire Nation flashed before my eyes. Nothing. The Fire Nation was nowhere to be found in the location of the mother nest. I could see empty chambers which once held teams of fire ants, brood, and formed the passageways frequented by queen and male elates, as well as Queen Solis. They were empty now, and ghost tunnels. But then a movement caught my eye. It was a lone supermajor crawling around in the soil. I also spotted a miner worker crawling around in the empty dirt. The truth made me so sad, but I had to accept it. AC family, I'm sorry to say that I believe the Fire Nation was on its final days. Our Queen Solis, the sole egglayer of the entire colony, must have died, and these ants here were the last remaining ants of her final batch of eggs. I'm so sorry, AC family. I'll be honest, I don't think I ever felt such sadness over the loss of a colony like I do now. Now that you guys know how epic the entire 4-year journey was with this amazing ant colony, you can probably understand why I cried when I realized I had lost these amazing, amazing creatures. I know, crying over ants. It sounds so weird to new ears, but it's just one of those things where you need to be there on the whole journey with them to understand. I felt like this was the end of an era for the entire antiverse. The end of the most amazing ant colony in the world, in my heart. I placed the driftwood piece back in its spot and left the Selva de Fuego to allow the final workers to live out their final days in peace. The Fire Nation was about 5 years old, and though I've been saying on this channel that though the workers only live for a couple of months, and that ant queens live for up to 30 years, I think I failed to clarify that this was assumed by the ant-keeping community, seeing as it was recorded in a German laboratory that a Lasius Niger queen lived that long. But the truth of the matter is, there are thousands of species of ants, and we haven't kept every ant species in captivity long enough to be able to verify and tell how long the queens of each ant species actually lives. I think the passing of the Fire Nation, assuming they didn't die out from some freak disease, has taught us that the queens of Solanopsis geminata, red tropical fire ants, live for about 5 years before passing away. Queen Solis must have died sometime in November, In a typical fire ant queen's life, during those five fruitful years, she lays millions of ants, spawning hundreds of generations of workers, creating hundreds of thousands of reproductive ants during nuptial flight season every year, which go on to mate with those of other fire ant colonies and continue on the species to complete the circle of life. The Fire Nation's passing was such a tough reminder that the circle of life is indeed a full circle, and our once booming fire ant colony was inevitably destined to come to an end and eventually die. Though the passing of the OG ant colony of the channel was sad, I also realized that we had learned so much from them over the years, and that they had not lived in vain. Some of the footage and discoveries we made of their intriguing secret lives in the soil and water during the course of the 4 years we followed them on this channel have not been documented by science. By providing the Fire Nation the best possible care we could give them to live out their best lives, they rewarded us back with such a wealth of info, discovery, and heart-stopping and adventurous moments. And that, to me, is the essence of what antkeeping is all about. I have been contemplating for a long time about what to do with the Selva de Fuego, now that it was devoid of an ant colony. Other than these feral ants, which, by the way, we need to discourage from being here. So I was hoping to get your opinions, AC Council. Should we get rid of the Selva de Fuego and rehome all the aquatic life? Or move in another of our ant colonies in here, like the Golden Empire or the Titans? Or should I try to find a brand new fledgling fire ant colony to start all over again from scratch? To be the Fire Nation successors? A Fire Nation 2.0 of sorts. Let me know in this iPoll here. AC family, this week, I lit a candle on our behalf to celebrate the life and death of one of the most amazing ant colonies in the world. Rest in peace to the Fire Nation. AC family, it was a tough 2 weeks for me. When I noticed the Fire Nation population had dwindled and then later discovered they had died out. But I suppose it's all part of the hobby. So much is in store ahead, so if you haven't yet, smash that subscribe button and bell icon now and hit all so you get notified at every upload. Because I believe notifications seem to be broken, but the YouTube support team is on it. Also, don't forget to hit the like button every single time, including now. It would really mean a lot to me. Thank you, guys. AC Inner Colony, I have left a hidden cookie for you here. If you would like to watch some extended play footage of some of my favorite memories of the Fire Nation. And now it's time for the AC Question of the Week. Last week we asked, which was your favorite creature featured in today's full pet ant tour? Congratulations to Alexander Churchill, who answered, I love Jabba the Hutt, the Suriname horned frog. Congratulations, Alexander. You just won a free ultimate antkeeping handbook from our shop. In this week's AC Question of the Week, we ask, which was your favorite memory of the Fire Nation? Leave your answer in the comment section, and you could also win a free ebook handbook from our shop. Hope you can subscribe to the channel as we upload every Saturday at 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Please remember to like, comment, share, and subscribe if you enjoyed this video to help us keep making more. It's Ant Love, forever.